I wanted to share with you my June 2014 Project Life pages. I used Scraptastic and Gossamer Blue subscription boxes to do a lot of these layouts. So let's zoom in and take a closer look. Okay, the first card is the title card for June. I just outlined it with some black so that it stood out more. And I loved the little pushpin wood veneers that came in the kit this month. And then this here is just the first picture I took of Salem, Pookie, and Maxwell. They're finally starting to accept the new cat, Maxwell. And I thought that was really cute. And it says number 3. Speaking of the new cat, Maxwell, he brought this lovely salamander into my home. And I spent the whole time on the countertops screaming at the top of my lungs. Thank God my husband was there to take apart the couches and find it, because I was not going to come down from the top of the counter until I found it, or he found it. And I used a Simple Stories flip card to expand this pocket, and I'm really starting to love these. I left the inside very plain because this part was so busy, I didn't want to take away from it. And what this is here is it says celebrate. This is important, and seriously, I hit 300 subscribers on my YouTube channel on June 26th, so I wanted to document that. For those of you that follow me, know that I keep track of that each month. And then up here, my poor husband had a kidney stone. Not fun. He had to have an MRI. The worst part about this situation is we were leaving to go to Lake of the Ozarks, and he passed the stone as we were packing and getting in the car. It wasn't as bad as we had originally, were expecting. So he said it wasn't bad. He took it like a trooper. He was really awesome about it. Okay, then on to this here is I wanted to use this Nurse Nora stamp. It is from CC Designs. It is a Swiss Miss. She is super cute. I thought it was the perfect time to use it. And then here is a guest check. And I really like the way this came out as well. The stamp that I used to create this was this little Band-Aid right here from the Healthy Vibes collection from Paper Smooches. And I also used this comforting stamp. And what this is my husband wanted to go to have his comfort food. You would think somebody that just had a kidney stone would not eat food like this, but that's my husband for you. He wanted to eat comfort food because he was so miserable. After he passed the stone, he felt much better, and he just wanted to get on the road with a good meal in his belly to head down to Lake of the Ozarks. Now, I do not have the Lake of the Ozark pictures in this video. They're going to be a separate video and separate pages. Let's go on to page 2. Okay, this is page 2 and 3. I wanted to put them together because they coordinated together and they sit next to each other in my binder, left and right. And I love the colors that were in this spread right here, or these specific 2 pages. So I wanted to show them together. Let's zoom in and take a closer look. Okay, for those of you that follow me on Instagram, you will recognize this card. I love the way it came out. It says June, summertime, this moment, here and now. I just absolutely love how it came out, so I did want to post it. I have a tendency to do that with cards that I like. This picture here is just a follow-up on my flowers. This is one of my favorite spots in my garden, and I just wanted to show the progression of my flowers. They're coming along really cute, and I loved this gold button that was in the kit for this month. It says, "You are treasured." Then there's a picture of my pond with my lilies and a little frog. I've been really happy with the progress of my pond, so I wanted to document it. And this is a statue of a little girl in another part of my garden. And again, it's showing that my flowers have really, really progressed, because in my May pictures, they were just planted and really tiny. This here I wanted to include. This was also in my May pages. This bench has become a really intricate part of our family, an important part of our family. This is where we gather at the end of the day, and the card says home sweet home, so I thought it worked out really well. And the filler card says, because when you stop and look around, this life is pretty amazing. And I just thought it looked really good together, and all the colors coordinated really well. And like I said, it's an important part of our home, so I wanted to document it. And then the last part is we did some work on the flower box in our yard. yard, and I love this stamp right here. It is from My Favorite Things, the Who's That Gal collection. It's called Who's That Garden Girl, and it's really cute because you can set up the box with any flowers that you want, and I picked these because they look really similar to the ones I planted there, and I love how that came out. I've added this arrow here so your eye is drawn over to the flower box, and probably one of my favorite parts of the spread this month. So let's move on to the next page. Okay, this is another progression card. I had shown this in May as well. This is a container garden class that I went to and the progress of the flowers that grew in it. And I'm really excited about that because I usually kill any potted plant that I've ever owned. So this one actually survived over a month. So I wanted to document that. The next card here is probably another favorite for this month. It says, always look for rainbows. The stamp that I used to create this card is from the Cat's Pajamas. It's called Hair Today. It's super, super adorable. My husband and I were going out to dinner and I took a picture of the rain on the windshield of our car, and I love the way it came out. Super cool. These here are just filler cards. I love these filler cards. I love the color combinations and everything that was included on them. And since I was doing home pictures, I wanted to include these. This banner here, I put some Tim Holtz alpha stickers that say home. This here, I love this burgundy color and the doily. I just added a cork butterfly and some rhinestones. And this here says home is wherever I'm with you, which is totally true. And here's that bench again. This is my little guy, Maxwell, my new cat. He loves hanging out on that bench, so I wanted to include that. And this picture is cute here. It says, boys are the best. It's my husband doing some yard work, and I don't know if he'd be thrilled about me calling him a boy, but he's definitely the best, so I wanted to document all the hard work he was doing. And then this last card is just goofy. We burn boxes here because we live out in the country. I'm originally from New York, and you can't do that in New York. We don't have recycle here, so this is the way we get rid of boxes. And I mean, with the boxes that I get here from all the hauls that I do and all the online ordering, we always have a lot, but we tend to do a lot more in the summer. So I always know summer is here when the boxes start getting burned at a high rate. Let's move on to the next pages. Okay, these are the next set of pages in my spread for this month. These are all cards from the Simple Stories Cat Collection, which I absolutely love. We're gonna zoom in and take a closer look at these pages. Okay, for those of you that know and follow me on Instagram and follow my past Project Life pages and stuff, you will know that we found a litter of 6 kittens on the side of the road abandoned, and my husband and I picked them up and we took them in and we took care of them and we fostered them and we adopted them out. So I wanted to document that because these kitty cats took up pretty much my whole entire month of June. This card is really cute. It says every life should have 9 cats. I think they were being sarcastic, but I actually had 9 cats. I had 3 of my own at the time, Salem, Maxwell, and Pookie, and then the 6th that I found. So it worked out perfect. This here is just the journaling that I did about finding the cats. This is my favorite stamp in my whole collection. It is called Birthday for Wren by Tiddly Inks. She is so cute. She has a cat hat and a cat balloon. So I wanted to add her to these pages. And then here are the kittens when I first found them. I fed them just a tiny bit because I knew that they were going to be really hungry. I don't know how long they were on the side of the road before I found them, but I wanted to definitely give them some kitten food, and they ate up, so that was really, really good. This here is a filler card. It says meow, and I added some stamping on this. I used a stamp set from the Paper Smooches called Charmed Cat. And I mean, this set was totally made for me. This says adopt, foster, transport, donate, and volunteer. And that's exactly everything I was doing. So I stamped that out and I used gold embossing powder. And then I wanted to show our morning and evening routine. This is what we did at night when we went to bed. We would all cuddle together on the bed. And this is how we woke up in the morning, all cuddled together in the little carrier that I brought them home with. I had left that in the room with the door open, and they used it as a bed. It was really, really cute. And this is the area where I found them, which was pretty terrible. Now, this picture wasn't taken on the day I found them because it was raining, thunder, lightning, storming. I went back a couple of days later to take this picture because I wanted to document where they were found. And basically, it was in a pricker bush in a ditch on the side of the road near a cornfield. So I'm really glad that I picked them up because with the storm that was coming that day, there was no way they would have survived. And we had bath time immediately after we ate. They were so dirty and filled with ticks, and I did not want them to go another night like that, so I wanted to wash them up. My husband and I took several hours, and we washed each one of them individually and dried them off so they had their bath time. Now, this card here, I didn't like at first, but I really like now, and I'm going to take it out to show it to you. What I did is I used the same stamp set from Paper Smooches called Charmed Cat, and I took a bunch of the sayings and I just stamped them all around and I heat embossed them with gold embossing powder. And I love the way this card came out. It's just so shiny and so super cute, and I added a bunch of sequins to fill in the gaps. And originally I did not like this card, but looking at it now, I absolutely love it. That was everything for this page. Let's move on to the next. Okay, this card here is really fun. It says, diagnosis OCD, obsessive cat disorder, and that's basically what my husband believes that I have. I created this card by combining two existing cards, and I love how it came out. Then this here is another one of those simple story flip pockets, because I wanted to do a lot of journaling about what happened with these cats. And this is cute. It says, don't look at me, the cat did it, and I found them in my bathroom tearing up the toilet paper. I learned really, really quick with these kittens to hide the toilet paper. And then this is just each of the individual cats. This one is Scaredy Pants. She was the hardest to pull out of the field. She probably took me about a half an hour to convince to come out. The other ones came up to me right away. This one was a little bit more tough, so we called her Scaredy Pants. But you can't blame her. It was thundering and lightning out and storming and very windy, and I would have been running away too if I were her. This one here we named Manny, and he reminded me of Christina Werner's Manny. Not exactly the same. His face has the black on both sides instead of just one side, but it's the first thing I thought of when I looked at him, so I named him Manny, and he was so super adorable. These were the twins, Louie and Yui. They were always together. Really loved them. They were so cute, and they had the best personalities. And this one here is Sissy. She was adorable as well. I think she was the smallest one in the litter. She was the runt, and she was just so super cute. And then this last one says, hello, my name is Bella. And the reason why I did a bigger card here is because for those of you that follow me on Instagram will know this is the cat that my husband and I decided to keep. She is so super adorable. These were her baby pictures, or the first pictures I have of her. And right here I stamped You're Perfect. It's from Paper Smooches called Chubby Chum Set. It's right here. And I heat embossed it with gold embossing powder. I just love how this card came out. And this die cut card that says, hello, my name is, was from a past Scraptastic kit. So I was really glad to be able to use it. And she was so adorable as a baby. And then this picture here is just my husband holding Bella and Manny. And as you can see, they were really, really tiny. Let's move on to the next pages. Okay, this first card is a filler card, but I love it. I love all the colors and the fonts on this. And this here says, all you need is love, and it is Manny, Bella, and Louie all huddled together, sleeping, taking a nap. And speaking of naps, my husband went in for a nap, and all the cats decided to join him. It was so cute. Now, this little kitty cat here is from a Simon Says stamp set called Catnap. I don't have it on hand to show you, but I colored him like Manny, because this picture of Manny right here. And if you can see, I have my hand out for him. You can just see how tiny this little guy was when we found him. I mean, it's just amazing that they survived this, and I'm so glad that they did. Here are the three white cats that I took a picture of all together. They were so cute all together. And this is another filler card that I created. And up here it says, you left a paw print on my heart. That again was from the Paper Smooches Charmed Stamp collection, and it's right here. You left a paw print on my heart. This stamp set was definitely made for me. I mean, as soon as I saw that, I mean, look at this stamp here. It says, who rescued whom? And that is so true. And here, this card is super funny. It says, the cat did it. I kept finding food on the floor and I couldn't figure out why, and I finally caught Manny in the act. He would go up to the bowl and dig the food out onto the floor. So I caught him in the act and I took a picture of it. I thought it was really cute. And I'm going to take this card out to show you a closer look of it. The element that I love on this page is this heartwood veneer. I had it left over from a February kit. I painted it with my Tim Holtz paints, and then I used Judikins embossing powder and iridescent sparkle on it. And that's the first time I've used this embossing powder. And as you can see, it is absolutely gorgeous and beautiful. So I wanted to show you a close-up of that. I really like that, and you're gonna probably see this technique more in future pages because it's so cool looking. Okay, and this is the final card in this page, on this page. It is a filler card, but I loved the paw prints, so I wanted to include it. And this little kitty cat here looks like my baby Salem, so I just thought I would include that as well. And they were definitely adored. So that was the final page for June, and hopefully I will have July, August, and September up soon. I've been having some problems filming, so just be patient with me. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. Thank you so much for watching. Bye! I'm not going to do that.